Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to Quad V, where we're bringing you guys live coverage of the FastHosts Power Tournament. We are going to be watching Western Wolves play it out versus Golden Oldies. Probably one of the toughest matches that both of these teams will be facing on their way to the finals to get themselves that first place prize of a lovely $2,750, which is up for grabs for them. We will be seeing Fantasy the Man finish it off on the knife round, and they will be able to decide what side they want to play. And it seems that Duffer instead rather wants to use rude language and not let us know what side they're going to be playing. but let's get back to some intros, guys. I am Menace, and alongside me I have Pansy. Pansy, how are you doing?
Not too bad, but I've got to say it. I am so excited about this game tonight because we've got such a veritable feast of fantastic players. Literally, you can just press tab and you see some of the very best there is. Whether, you know, you go back a couple of years, they'd still be at the top of the scene. You've had Toxgy, who's been away from the game for a couple of months. He's returning now to take the place, I believe, of Revolts for this game, who, well, we don't know where he is right now. But for Golden, I'll just give you a little bit of a roster rundown, just give you an idea of what you're in for tonight. So for the Golden Oldies side, Elking, Raz, Katana, Toxgy, and Duffer. And moving over to the rather well-known Western Wolves, Froz, Ono, Fantasy, Chubby, and Meissen. So an absolutely formidable side to come up against for Golden Oldies, especially with a Merc as such. You know, I don't think you can say Toxgy's a full-on Merc, but nevertheless, surely that's going to ring some alarm bells and really put them up against it. How do you think this game's going to go, Menace?
Yeah, I mean, like you said, it's going to be a little bit weird playing with a person that might not be familiar with the playstyles of the team, but we also have to step back a moment and see that Meissen's got 170 ping. So I think it's going to even it out a bit, because Meissen with a ping like that, it's going to struggle. It's going to bring him back. It's an unfortunate part of online playing, but it's not one of those things we have to live with. So we've got Meissen on a high ping. Duff is timing out at the moment, probably be back in a bit. Toxgy, yeah. Again, I think his playstyle is very adaptable, especially playing AK or SMG, one of the two. But it's an adaptable playstyle. He should be able to fit in with the team. I mean, I've played with him a couple of times. He's very disciplined. If you ask him to do something, he'll do it. And simply on that basis, I don't think he should be a massive hindrance to the team. It does look like we are just going to have a Duffer timing out for a moment. Oh, he is back. And we do see Ono and Fan both sporting the Heart Daisy tag. As with the recent phenomenon of days, I'm pretty sure everyone's been loving the game so far. I've been playing it loads. Pretty sure you've been doing the same, Pansy. Either way, it is the first round, and if you don't mind, I'm going to be taking it away with the lovely scopes in this game. We're going to be having Ono going up against Katana in the scope battle. We have got Ono watching into that death alley over on that B side. He's not going to see anyone cross. He's got his two teammates going towards B, two teammates going towards A, and a little bit of a geek nade. I think that's going out towards Car Park. Looks like the Golden Oldies at the moment are just kind of poking around. They're still stuck towards that spawn side. Duffer has been able to get a frag onto Fan. This has been the first frag of the game, but Chibi quickly replying. Harassing him with AK, we might see him switching up to a shotgun. I really hope we do, because the shotgun play is loads of fun to watch. He has spotted a player up in mid. He's going to be going up onto that wall there. He wants some cover to work with. Has spotted AK off to his left-hand side. Golden Earl is currently the man in the lead. Raz is slightly tagged up, but he should be able to regen that health. He knows that there's one in mid. He's going to be careful of it, although with Ono giving away his position in mid, that'll mean that Raz can really focus on their play over towards B side. He seems a bit uncertain at the moment, so he's going to be switching over, maybe going to go try and reinforce his teammate over on that A site. We have got Froz rotating back all the way from B. And that's one of those things, they have to try and work with their team as much as they can. They seem to be pretty confident that the Golden Oldies are going to be going towards the A site, so they both are in position for it. We do see Katana taking out Froz. Ono now coming under some heavy fire. Katana is spraying him down, and if anyone can take out or either one of these players, it'll be Ono or Katana. Both of these guys are so incredibly skilled. Ono does sneak away, though, and with that, I think he's just trying to draw some attention away from his position. Going to make his way down the stairs. I don't think he's been spotted. He's going to come around this corner. Unfortunately, two players looking in his direction, and none of them actually spot him in the start. Katana finally standing up after getting that bomb down. Will take out Ono. And Katana really coming up big that round towards the end of it. 2-0 for him in the first round. Looking strong so far for the Golden Oldies on the first round.
For sure. Picking up with Katana, who literally played such a pivotal role that last round. Really went all the way around Flower. Put the pressure right onto Western Wolves, but he does manage to land the opening shot onto Ono. But Elking will drop a nade onto his face regardless of that situation. So already Golden Oldies with a slight advantage on the attacking side, which is always going to put them in good stead. But we've seen Duffer do it time and time again. He's worked his way through mid, dropped down Chubby. It's really opening this map up. So you can see they've worked the frag into AR just to really alleviate the pressure. Froz replying finally with the nade onto Raz at mid. Elking just slapping them back into place. Golden Oldies looking so strong so far. You can see the bomb's made its way to A, and there's two players left for Western Wall to live. Fantasy on the prowl through spawn. Let's pick up with him. SMG to hand. There's no one watching the car park as of yet. I think there's a player just rotating now. It's Katana, the man coming up so strong right now. One man stands for Western Wolves, and it is Froz. Let's see if he can make any odds right now. Three players alive. It's a tough ask for anyone. 30 seconds on the board. He's got the tags coming in. Can he return any of the shots? Yes, he can. He does tag up an inch of someone's health. It was Duffer, but Duffer is really putting him under the pressure. 22 seconds on the board, and it looks like it's a no-man situation. There we go. Duffer finally shuts him down. But I've got to say it. As much as I love the other players on this map, I remember do this every time. Picks up that SMG, and he'll literally control mid like an SMG should. You know, he really gets that opening pick with the SMG, opens up one of the arches, and just allows his team to flood through. So make sure you keep your eye open for that one.
Now, as you mentioned, I mean, we finished off the last round. There were three players still alive for Golden Oldies. The round before, there was two alive. So if anything is going in a pattern here, we're going to see Golden Oldies alive with four players at the end of this round. But so far, looking very strong, seemingly finding every flaw they can in the moment in Western Wolves' defense. And no doubt they'll be rectifying that one as soon as they can. We've got Duffer timing out. Unfortunately, Froz is going to get an easy pick on him, although Raz sitting over on the wooden side. Oh, he had his spidey senses tingling. Takes out Fan as Fan just peeks around the corner. Raz trying to re-peek Froz, but you don't re-peek Froz. Everyone just knows you do not do that. We do see Katana coming on under heavy fire from Meissen. Meissen easily picking up that frag as Katana tries to get some defense going. Western Wolves looking strong so far. They are currently the man in the lead as they move forward into this round. Some shots being exchanged in mid. Elking wants to go for that plant, but it's going to be so difficult with the players right there. Meissen takes out Toxia. There's no way Elking's going to get this bomb down. He's given away his position. Froz is waiting on the covering position. And there we go. It's going to be 2-1. Western Wolves picking up their first round in the first map in the first half.
Indeed. And it seems though Duffer has just absolutely made a mess of things. But I think we'll be going live shortly. I don't know what's going on with Duffer right now. Well, there's a lot of things going on with Duffer, but I don't know what's affecting this game currently. We're just waiting on the Golden Oldies side to ready up. But if I was Western Wolves right now, they've seemed to have adapted pretty quickly. But that slow A mid push was really working for the Geo side. You know, they've been sending Duffer through mid, and as soon as he got there, he'd take down Chubby or whoever thought was standing in their way and just keep going. So I'm going to pick up with Duffer now. Actually switched up the SMG for an AK and let Elking run with it. So let's pick up with Elking. Let's see if he can make his way through mid. Does do the well-renowned Mama Root there just to avoid any quick nades. Now going straight through mid. Feeling confident. Drops down Frost with the nade onto B. So they opened up this B side really early on. A player has snuck through to the ice cream van. Who is it? It was Chubby, but not for long. Toxie's SMG rings out a few shots. Takes it down. Fancy takes down the first, which was Elking. Finally a reply. But is it too little too late for the Western Wolf side in this round? Let's find out. Oh no, rotating around from eight, but the bomb is down. So that's giving the Western Wolves a bit of a time limit to work to here. Does get the tag on B. Toxie laying out the fire, but doesn't manage to land the shot onto Meissen, who's now at the top of the street. Gets thoroughly tagged through the wall. Meissen dropping down. Duffer as well, taking the shot onto Ono. And now one man stands is Fantasy, our very favourite person right now. In a world of trouble in B Arch, there's a player above him. There's a player to his right, to the left. Can he get any of them? Yes, he can. Drops down Raz. Spins around. Three men remain. For long, the round was truly put to a halt there by Katana. And at the moment, I'm surprised how versatile Golden Oldies are looking. They're looking like they're not afraid to go to A or B or mid, and they're just using every single route possible.
I mean, going up against a team like this, most players might get a little bit nervous. They might feel a little bit, you know, sketchy about their usual attack plans. They might start doubting themselves. But Golden Oldies right now, just, you know, standing to what they know, playing on their strengths, and just seem to be annihilating any of the Western Wolves players that stand in their way. Now let's have a little bit of a look here. We do see Duffer, his teammate, pushing through mid. Meissen's already gone down early on. Toxia's going to watch the rotate. Let's out a smoke, and a nade might be picked off as he does so. Oh, he's got a player coming just around the corner. It is Ono. Ono with a deagle, though, coming up on form. Where is a Fan? He's going to be rotating all the way around the back. Let's give him a little bit of a spectate. Let's see how he plays this one. It is very difficult to try and hold his position in mid. I mean, of course, he's got the stairs to his left-hand side. His partner's covering it up in mid, so he shouldn't be too worried, although with that partner going down, He'll have to try and fill in that gap. Smoke's gone out and trying to push into a smoked A arch with the bomb going down. It's very difficult. We do see Froz falling extremely quickly. Fans going to be walking over here to an open arch. Goes for the first one and he lands the second one onto Duffer, and we're easily able to get that defuse. And that'll push his team up to a 3-2 scoreline, closing off that gap. But that was so incredibly close, and that was such a difficult position to push. But both of them pushing at the same time, I'm pretty sure just threw off the Western Wolves, the Golden Oldies side, and they did not expect both of them to just be walking through the smoke.
No, definitely not. And now it does seem as though there's a couple of players I really quickly clocked from the Golden Oldies side had an A spawn. But it seems as though they're happy going B. They're not doing just the spawns, they're really splitting it. So let's pick it up with Fantasy. Everyone loves the man, and he did go huge last round. He's holding B with the SMG currently, really taking the pressure right to the Golden Oldies players down by Ice Cream Van, just darting around close. Does spot on towards that zigzag alley, gets a shot out, but Toxi is mopping up his teammates right now. Mighten down, Ono soon to follow. Toxi is on an absolute rampage and he's not stopping. The man's been away for months and it doesn't matter. Finally, Froz takes a stand, dropping down Duffer, his teammate. Can Fantasy even up a little bit more? Yes, he can. Raz looking a little bit rusty to say the least, but is a 2v3. Favour to Golden Oldies, but the bomb is ticking. So there's a time limit to what Western Wolves can do. 37 seconds on the board. Fantasy is in a arch. So if he gets this player in spawn, he can really open up this A side, but I doubt he would assume he's there. Very unorthodox position. Darting through A arch, you can see his teammates behind him, but he does get the tag onto who was it? It doesn't matter, it was Toxi, but the man is on fire. And you don't try and grab a man on fire, do you now? Because Toxi has just gone absolutely huge. Takes down Froz, takes down Fantasy, and takes the round right away from Western Wolves. And the man looks like he hasn't been gone for a single day.
Now that was really stellar stuff there from Toxi. Sitting on 10-4 at the moment. You could not ask for a better start. Now I have to do this, because Koji is one of my big buddies, right? Massive fan of the COD 4 community, and he actually personally messaged me to tell everyone in the community, shout out to the community, and that he loves us all, because currently we've got 920 viewers. We have a downed, our main community website is down, and we're pulling these numbers, so massive shout out to everyone in the community. Great seeing all the support. Now we do see the Golden Oldies are trying to push over towards this B side. They're coming under heavy fire though. Honor is laying down brilliant cover with that scope and covering his teammate down there on the fences. We do see Duffer trying to push in. Elking and Katana, they're making their way towards A. It's all a bluff over on B as where the real action is on A. There's only one player in the arch from the Western Wolf side, and I don't think he'll be able to stop it. Elkin goes in front of the fake. Meissen goes down. They'll be able to get this bomb down with absolute ease, and even though they lost the player over on the B side, it does not matter, because now it is all up to Western Wolves to try and bring this one back. You see Ono trying to rotate through mid, although unfortunately for him, he's going to fall right in front of Tokshay's aim. Does do so, and goes down. Now Tokshay once again, he knows where Froz is right here in mid. He's going to lay down some covering fire. He doesn't need to die. He knows he doesn't. There's still loads of time on the clock, and he doesn't want to give Froz any chance. We do see Froz, they're finally going down towards the AK of Elking, and that'll push Golden Oldies three rounds into the lead as they're currently sitting on 5-2.
Indeed. I'm going to watch Ono here, see if he's up to anything. He looks a little bit AFK, looks a little bit confused. He's thinking, what the hell's going on? Golden Oldies are absolutely storming us right now. The attacking side is on 5-2, they're only defensive two rounds. And normally this is a slightly defensively biased map, so you'd expect Western Wolves to be just in the lead. But maybe that touch of an inactive period has really put them in their place. But Duff has made his way through mid once again, taking down Chubby and Froz. Fan finally replying, taking down Duff with that SMG. Now all the action has left Fantasy, leaving a little bit of space to move around, and he's made his way to the opposing spawn. Can he get the frag? He shoots a dead body. That's not going to pose you much threat, but the body on the right may just do that, and Toxi does. Toxi is the danger man currently for Golden Oldies. He's all the way on the top of the scoreboard with 13-4. Closest anywhere near him is Froz on 9-7 on the opposing side. So this man is truly running away with the game. 2v2. So it's possible that, who knows, Western Wolves could claw around back and keep themselves in this game. Let's find out if they can do just that. I'm picking up with Toxi because the man is really in the game right now. But there is a player at B. It is Ono. Ono in a 1v2 gets the first frag onto Elking, dropping him down with a fantastic headshot. Can he follow suit onto the man of the moment, which is Toxi? Picks up the AK, knows where the bomb is now, so Ono can play pretty chilled. He can depend on his teammates coming. No, he can't, because Toxi is putting the pressure right into him. 1v1. Toxi's got a bit of time here. He can really work the map as he pleases. Spots him at the top of the street. That is Meissen as well. The man, I can imagine, has got a bit of a ping. So Toxi's feeling confident he shouldn't have done. He overreached and gets punished for it by Meissen with that AK at the top of the street. But yeah, big shout out to Koji as well from myself. He's such a great guy towards his community. Show all the love for him. And, you know, as well to D-Cell, who was in chat earlier. And, you know, I've got to say hello to him because he's an awesome guy. But what a game so far. I can't believe how much pressure Golden Oldies have put onto Western Wolves. They seemed unstoppable at that recent match.
They don't really so, but they seem to be playing this distraction game very well. Once again, they've got two players going towards A, two players going towards B. They're pretty much seeing, well, let's see where we can clear it up, but let's still apply heavy pressure on either bomb site. And it's going to make Western Wolves get kind of like, okay, do we, you know, put more strength into A? Do we put more into B? Where do we rotate the players? And it seems to just be splitting them down the middle. Duffer's push through mid has been so successful so many rounds in a row. Honor pushing down B Street, don't think that's a very smart idea. We do see him going down to the hands of Raz, who used to be the COD 4 player of the year, but he was back in 2009.
Long time ago.
Now, Chibi coming in from behind, though, takes out Raz, and that is going to alert the man over on B. Who is that? That is Toksha. He's just going to turn around and make an absolute... I mean, literally just walks over Chibi. There wasn't even a question. Chibi did not even have enough time to pull the trigger. And now Mice on your last man standing. He was playing over on the B side last round, so the Golden Oldies team should maybe realize that he could still be there. But then again, Western Wolves, like I said, they are very maneuverable. They're very agile. They're quick to rotate. And, oh, is Toksha going to be taken out? No, Meissen!
Let's
his position get known just a little bit too early, and Toksha actually gets the barrel frag. Toksha's sitting in 9 rounds on 16 frags. Now, if you're a public COD 4 player, that's, like, massively easy. You can do that with your eyes closed. Doing that in pro mod against this team, not that easy.
No way, that is insane. So let's pick up with Toksha, let's see what he's doing. Oh, so right. I feel as though he's come back to the game with no fear. You know, you take those breaks, and well, he should have been fearing Chibi because he just came wandering out of A-Arch, and indeed, as you put it, it was commentator's curse. But it feels as though a lot of the players always say, you know, I play better when I come back after, you know, a break. But really, I think it's just that lack of fear. You know, a lot of people wouldn't have gone for that rush that Toksha just did because there may have been a fast nade, or there may have been that SMG player pushing up A. So we can see Golden Oldies really dedicating themselves to this A push currently. And finally a reply comes in from someone other than Chibi. It was Ono with the first rake, followed up with the second Deagle onto Elking after dropping Raz with that lovely scope shot from the A arch. Chibi is beside him as well. So there are teammates to assist towards A. But where are these players going? Katana is left on the A-bomb. The bomb is actually loose on the floor. Duffer has gone walkabouts to B. He's hoping to kind of rotate around them. So we're going to pick it up with him. Can he get the frag at the top of the street? No, he can't. Ono made his way just there as well. Ono picking up a hat trick this round already, leaving it all on Katana. Let's see if he can do any of this German magic I hear so much about. And no, he can't because Chibi was standing there. And Chibi played such a pivotal role that round, playing very passive. Apart from that initial frag onto Toksha, obviously. But really clawing back the round to getting those frags that really matter.
Now, some people are already saying that Toksha will be the MVP of this game. My criteria for an MVP, though, he must be able to be consistent. He should be able to replicate these results in the second map and let Golden Oldies take the win. So once he does that, by all means, he's got the MVP, guys. But for now, let's just marvel in his brilliance for the time he has. We do see Western Wolves actually being very aggressive on their defense. They're pushing up quite far. We do see Froz peeking out of that laundry area. Ooh, Ono coming under some heavy fire. He does actually go down. Katana's already pushed over towards B side. But unfortunately for them, they've dropped the bomb at the top of mid stairs, which means one of them is going to have to rotate. Oh, and Katana gets caught off by Chibi. Chibi coming all the way over from A, realizing that his team is in need of him. Does he spot the bomb, though? I don't know if he has. I'm pretty sure he has spotted it. He should have spotted it. Chibi, go back. Get some cover, dear man.
He's feeling brave.
Looks like he's going to go into a mid. I don't know if he spotted the player on the stairs, though. He is laying down. He's expecting someone to walk in front of him. Oh, but will he have quick enough reactions? He does, too. Takes out Duffer. He's looking for the second one. He's looking in the right direction, but Toksha just... Wow, his reaction is just second to none. And once again, gets the final frag, and that'll see Golden Oldies tank other one. Now, this is the thing, like... I mean, Western Wolves are playing a very good straight line defense, but unfortunately, Toksha being like the spear.
Chibi's on the push.
Is just penetrating
up with
so
Chibi.
Quickly.
Chibi's picking up the first hit onto Raz. There's a lot of players around him. Can he follow this pace up? Let's find out. He knows he's not a B pusher. He's going to tell his teammates, focus on A, guys. I made my way through mid. I stopped the push straight away. And maybe they heard what you said almost. Maybe they literally heard in the background, guys, we're being pretty passive here on defense. Why aren't we being more aggressive? Why aren't we pushing these as much as we can? He really get in their faces. And now it does seem as though Chibi did do just that. And now the pressure is definitely being put onto A. Meissen getting the frag onto Duffer with that AK work. Touching with the reply. Just avenging his fallen teammate. Now Elking with the bomb, though. This A push is truly coming to fruition as there is two players in A arch, though. For the Western Wolf side, really stacking up here. Fantasy being one of them has to avoid these nades. It could be raining in. There is a player on A. Being careful. Fantasy spots him. Doesn't get the tag or the frag, but he does know they're there. That's enough for his teammates for now. They're playing smart and careful. Toksha get tagged up a touch, and there we go, Elking breaking the silence with the frag onto Ono, who's been desperately quiet this game, especially for Ono. Normally he's the man at the top of the scoreboard, but right now we can barely see him. And here we go, fire coming out left, right and centre. Toksha picks up the first onto Chibi, now is almost all on Fantasy under absolute tyranny. Arch, but Froz dives in, gets a quick frag onto Katana, and Toxie Fancy finally mops up Elking. But too little too late, it seems. But that was such an obscure round. You know, it seems as though Chubby really kicked off the right direction, but he took just almost the wrong route, if you know what I mean. Like, he went down B alley, like, you know, death alley almost. And if he'd have pushed through spawn straight away and kept that aggressive push up, he'd have got probably a 3 or 4 man quite comfortably, and it's just the luck of the game, I feel. So, but eventually, they've actually kind of landed on a fairly decent scoreline. You'd expect it to be the other way around, personally. I'd expect Western Wolves to come out the better of the initial side, being on, obviously, defense. But I feel as though it could be either the game right now. There's no easy way to call it. I think that if Tokshi doesn't manage to keep up the pace, then, you know, Golden Oldies might, you know, have crumbled a bit, because Raz, you can also see on the scoreboard, is on 3-11. So he's really not performing today. But, you know, with, you know, someone like Tokshi on top, maybe you don't have to. But as it's the first round diving in, why don't you take us away into the second half of the first map?
So, yeah, second half, first map. And guys, if you did just join us, welcome. This is Quad V bringing you guys live coverage of the FastHosts Power Tournament. Currently covering Western Wolves versus the Golden Oldies. It is the first map, as just said. And I am Menace alongside me. I have got Pansy. And so far, it looks like we are seeing the unexpected. And this is another thing. I mean, the way it started for Western Wolves was very bad. And it's not going any better at the moment as Elking grabs two frags. But, I mean, it's a lot better than what it could have been for them. We can always say it in that light, though. You can always say something, oh, it could have been better than, you know, if I lost a leg or something. But, you know, 7-5 isn't all that bad. And it's by all means, they can still come back from it.
Ooh, oh no.
Now we do see Elking on this A defense, takes out the first one, spots the second one. 4 frags, first round, Elking.
Comfortable.
What can you
casual.
Do?
Elking just keeping it cool, calm, and collected. The man didn't even seem fazed by the opposing side. He just kind of, you know, he just strolled into it, you know, dropping 4 guys from Western Wolves. It seems like nothing. So speaking of the Chubby, let's see if he can just match what Elking just did. Does make his way through Death Alley, which if he didn't take before, he could have got a beautiful set of kills. Now he's made his way out on B, and there's no one there to oppose him, but Katana drops down 2 of his teammates so quickly. It's gone in a split second. This B push has lost all the pace, but what a deagle. Can he follow up with another shot? No, he can't. Raz is truly tagged at the top of the street there, but the smoke is pluming out onto B, allowing him a little bit of freedom to make his way into the arch here. Can he get a frag onto play? Just to his right, doesn't manage to see Duffer, and Duffer comes up huge, just really taking down the threat that already pushed up street. So now the Western Wolves attacking side has been absolutely crumbled to just 2 players, which I believe it's Ono and Froz. So let's see if Ono's got any chance of hitting any of these shots. There's players around him, but he's off form, and Katana isn't. The German scope is absolutely meticulous, but not meticulous enough to take down Froz. But Raz is. Raz with a lovely shot, finally. Just waking up after getting really shot in the face by Chubby. He's going, you know, giving him a good old slap around until he woke the hell up. But we can see the defensive side really pulling away with the first map here. Do you think this is just a map thing? Do you think Western Wolves just need this kind of wake-up tool to go, guys, you know, you've been out of it for a while, get back into this, you know, it's not going to be a walk in the park.
Yeah, I mean, I definitely agree. I think we could be seeing just the thing of they need to get into the game a bit. Like you said, people that haven't been playing in the game, why perform really well, like, you know, the first couple of games or so when they come back, whereas Western Wolves pretty much play every day. So just warming it up, getting themselves into that stride, and then probably should see them back on the on a better form. Maybe this is just their worst map, and Golden Oldies are just having a field day at the moment. We do see Toxin, now currently your last man standing. So Katana, it's not being made all too easy, and we'll be seeing Honor grab that final frag. So the 3-round difference though, and still in the favor of Golden Oldies, and that's where Western Wolves need to start getting a little bit worried.
Yeah, you don't let it slip any further. Here it's manageable, but that round difference, just mentally, it puts you right off. You're already on the back foot. So let's pick up with Chubby here. He has made his way through Death Alley once again. Hopefully 2 of his teammates don't drop down to another one of Katana's absolute bombs. But here we go. Chubby with a quick plus 10, shutting down Duffer and Raz, really punishing the Golden Oldie side for resting on their laurels. Now he's pushed up to the top of the street just to secure it even further. But Katana takes a stand with that scope, slams a headshot straight out there. And now we see it almost all even. And finally, Western Wolves with the advantage actually into round. Do go for the bomb hunt onto B. Froz shutting down Katana. And now this is looking very much like a Western Wolvesy map. Can they finally close out a round even? Let's find out with the bomb down. The clock is ticking, but Golden Oldies do have players, 2 players standing, and Toxi is still alive. And the man was on a mission we saw on the other half. Can he continue the pace? Elking drops down Fantasy. Oh, no. Replying. Nope. So now it's all on Toxi. Fire coming in towards him from that fence area. 26 seconds on the board. And he hasn't got a lot of time to do much, but Froz is the first to fall. Can he continue the pace? Spots on. Oh, yes, he can. It's a 1v1. Meissen against Toxi. 18 seconds on the board. The clock is ticking, folks. The pressure is on. Can he go huge? No, he can't. At the last hurdle, Meissen pops up and drops the AK shot right into his face. But that was a little bit too close to comfort, I feel.
That was pretty close. And you know what was funny to me? Up until that round, Froz was the only player that was actually on a positive kill-death ratio. And that really does stand out to me a bit when it comes to the whole kind of team play and, you know, trying to get those frags. But it seems to be picking up for them just a little bit. It seems like they've found a gap in their bead defense from the Golden Oldies side. And it looks like Meissen with that ping just does not seem to be working out with him so well. And he's been left to sit back towards the spawn side. There is a player towards the B arch. He's not actually looking that way. He's got a player pushing up towards him. He's got to be very careful. Does drop to Elking's AK instead. And now this is where Golden Oldies are just pretty much surrounding Western Wolves right now. They've got players on the top of the fences area. They've got a player in mid. They've got a player all the way back on the attacking team's catwalk area. So they are pretty much being surrounded at the moment. It's going to be very difficult for them to either get the bomb down or try and get out of this position. And Toxi has a nice little spot here, peeking into the arch. He has spotted a player there. Froz takes out Katana, and it looks like Toxi is now going to have to move in, but he shouldn't be moving into the same position where his teammate is. Looks like Fan wants to peek out towards the arch. Fire does come in, and I think that's pretty much given away both of the Golden Oldies players' positions in mid. Oh, they're going for a rotate, though. Oh, dear. Who is that? Oh, it's Froz. He's snuck all the way over towards A side. This is definitely not expected from Golden Oldies. They're still trying to work their way over towards B. I think it's going to be given away as soon as this first plant goes down. Froz shouldn't fake it. He's not going to. Oh, but Fan's there. He's got to be very careful. He needs to try and get away as quick as he can. Fire comes in. Sorry, it's Toxi. Toxi goes down. Fan tries to get the reply. Fan trying to cover, but now Toxi can quickly run and defuse. Oh, wait. No, that was... Sorry, I got the teams completely mixed up. That's it. That was Fan down. Fan couldn't defend the bomb. Golden Oldies take another round and keep that three-round lead. And it's just looking so good for them right now. Fan even going for a reconnect.
He's not feeling too comfy right now, it seems. Maybe maybe there's some settings going on, maybe a technical issue, who knows. Or maybe just to give him a clean slate when he looks at the scoreboard. But I'm in the same position as you, if I'm honest. Seeing, you know, obviously the likes of Toxi with Golden Oldies. And, you know, you could literally go back, let's say, in the last 3 years of COD 4. And you could probably mix these teams around, and it have happened at some point. You know, it's so hard remembering, you know, where these guys have been and now where they are. Because it's a jumble of players, you know. I never thought, you know, Fantasy, I believe, you know, used to play with half the guys on the opposing side.
Yeah, used to be in Dignitas with Raz and them.
Yeah, exactly. I think, wasn't Elking there for a short stint?
Was there?
Do you know what, guys? If you know better than me. Exactly. In Rio, at some point, was in Dig with Jermaine. And literally, it's such an incestuous community. It's unbelievable, folks. Surprised they don't have, like, eight fingers on one hand. But we are just waiting on four players to ready up, which is two from Western Wolves and two from Golden Oldies. But it's such a great game, and I'm so happy to see Toxi on absolute storming form. 22-9. It's sensational work from him, and it's nice to see a game that's really dependent on the SMG work. A lot of the times, you know, on this map, you see it really heavily dependent on the scopes, but it seems as though they're taking quite the back seat currently. Obviously, Katana always playing quite well. He's on 10-12, average scoring, you know, nothing major. But then you look at Ono as well. He's, you know, he's not really shining like usual. It's really dependent on if those SMGs get the good spawns and use them properly. So I'm going to pick up with Fantasy here, who is more the supporting SMG, it seems, with Chubby at the moment. Chubby's been getting the front spawns and really been working as best he can. Frost kicking this off in the right direction for Western Wolves' comeback, but Katana shuts it down right where it started with another nade into Fantasy's face. Now, let's pick up with Katana here. He is looking across the mid. Can he spot anyone? No, he can't. Look how defensive they are. They're feeling really scared.
1,000 views.
Indeed, and big thank you to all of you viewing so far. Keep getting the stream out there. It is well and truly worth it. Meissen stands up, takes down Duffer, and finally Western Wolves with the advantage. They did lose a man fairly early on, but they clawed it back. So let's see if they can push this attack to one of the sides. Toxi is raring to go. You can see him holding back just a touch, but now he's just sneaking his way up from B. Chubby with a frag onto Katana, but is this too little too late? Toxi spots one, gets the frag, gets the second onto Chubby. Meissen down, Chubby down. Two more to go, and I wouldn't put it past the man right now, because Froz gets that bomb down at A. Now you can see that the attacking side are going to split up the way they're defending this. So one will be towards Car Park, one will be towards more the Flower House. So literally, if one falls, the other got it covered. They'll refringe frag it straight away. Now 30 seconds on the board. Toxi getting tagged up a touch. It was manage to spot where one is possibly, but the clock is ticking, and it's ticking pretty fast now, Tokshi. You want to get moving. Moved a little bit too far. Froz pops up, drops him down casually with that AK, and the scoreline is getting ever closer. And Western Wolves seem to be closing out these rounds as well. They're not rushing it. It seems as though they've kind of, even if they lose the player early on, if they catch a nade or something silly, they can work that frag back somehow, which is what we saw last round.
Yeah, it really is starting to get very close. Little quick heads up, guys, if you do want to check out any of our other content, go like us on Facebook at QuadV, at QuadV on Twitter, and of course /QuadVTV on YouTube, where you can check all our videos on demand. Other than that, like, let's get right back into this matchup. We do see some heavy pressure coming out here onto the B side. Western Wolves seem to be a lot more of, they go all aggressive on the one side rather than the way Golden Oldies were playing, where they put two players to a site and see where they can open up the player. Now, it looks like a lot of the players for Golden Oldies have actually rotated over towards B. There's only one player sitting towards the Western Wolves spawn, which is Elking. He's taken up Froz. Meissen is completely confused, finally realizes, wait a minute, we shouldn't have someone there. Turns around, gets a frag, and now we will be seeing that only Meissen and Shubi are left alive. By all means, this is within their grasp. They can do it if they work together. They just need to work very well together. Shubi unfortunately coming under some heavy fire. Meissen trying to lay down some cover, but there's too much aggression coming in from every angle. There's just no way he can flick quick enough between all of them, and now currently stuck in a position where it's going to be difficult for him to get out of it. And there we can see it, two players just watching his positioning, and Meissen will go down, and that'll be 11-8. Two more rounds, and Golden Oldies will be taking the first map in the FastHosts Power Tournament right now.
Exactly. So let's pick up the katana here, and just a quick reminder, so everyone who's just tuned in, this is for a massive prize pot. This overall tournament is £5,000 worth. That is a lot of money for an online tournament, and that is thanks to obviously the FastHosts guys, the Game Shadow guys, and the Epic LAN team especially for really organizing this. And let's see if Tokshi can just do them right proud right now, as he does take down Meissen Katana with a frag from himself onto Chubi, giving Gold Oddies a huge advantage into this round that really is so pivotal. Raz keeping up the pace onto Ono, our recent Counter-Strike, you know, GO star. He's been trying very hard to get into that game, but he's not doing too well right now, as Froz does drop down to the scope work of Katana as well. Now the one man stands. It is Fantasy really pinned in at A, and he's in a world of trouble. Picks up the bomb and the AK, but Katana rattling off the shot within a split second of him peeking. And it's just given them that round that you dread to see on the board. They're on that little marker that just makes it seem just that bit impossible almost.
This is now the map point, break point in tennis. The eagle versus someone's birdie in golf. Either way, they're going to be in the lead if they win the next round. And we do see Tokshi just once again starting off on form. Takes out Froz, AK down for the Western Wolf side. We do see Elking trying to hold out here over on this A side. He has got his teammate with him. Duff is still playing in mid. He has actually been very aggressive, and this is quite late into the round for him. We do see Katana grab the frag there onto Chibi. Western Wolves currently the player down. Oh, Elking's response was a little slow then. Fan picks him off. That did Fan hear the player towards his right hand side. Takes out Katana too. And here we go. Fan saves it there for his team, getting three frags in the last couple of seconds. Pivotal frags for him. Literally pivotal. You know, like the point in the seesaw where things go from one side to the other one. That was pivotal stuff, because that's morale, that's momentum, everything's gone for Golden Oldies.
Exactly. So let's see if Fantasy can really keep up what they just started. Elking putting his tracks almost with that AK work onto Chubi, one of the really aggressive SMGs. Katana following suit, dropping down Ono just to avenge him after death somehow with the car exploding. But Fantasy has made his way to mid, and he is literally holding the push of almost the whole Golden Oldies side. If they manage to rotate towards A, at least two, maybe three will have to come past him. So let's find out if he can do that. And the nades are raining in towards the A side. And one of the actual nades did tag up Tokshi, but didn't manage to go down. Raz uses that AK to an absolute perfect amount, taking down Fantasy, leaving it all on two players, Froz and Meissen. Let's see if either of them can do this. Here we go. Froz does manage to get the frag and now going for the bomb plant onto A. This could be explosive better site planted to plant on with two people remaining. Here we go. Can they manage to shut down that guy in car park? No, they can't, because Duffer's there! And Duffer goes huge. The man comes up when it matters. And there we go. Golden Oldies will be picking up the first map in this best of three. But can you believe it? I would have thought Western Wolves would have stormed through this.
I thought so too, but I just love the way, because as soon as I saw Duffer coming around Cardbox, the only thing I thought was
Duffer.
It's Duff from Recent Gaming.
It's Duffer.
Everything dies and it's all gun flaring, yes. And he just wins it in style for his team. And that's going to be it, guys. That was the first map. Don't worry, there's going to be more action. It's a best of three, so there will be a second map that will now be chosen by the losers of of the first map. So Western Wolves get to decide what map they want to play now. I'll be moving over to that one soon. They might be taking a little bit of a break, but we'll be keeping you informed if that does happen. Other than that, this is Quad V bringing you guys live coverage from the FastHosts Power Tournament. This is first map done. Western Wolves unfortunately lose a 13-9. But do stick around. We'll be back right back for the second map.